Now, I know there's a couple of solutions out there, but I definitely believe that the SCP driver works pretty well for what we want to do. So,
bruh.
Hey, what up? This is Eddie 04, and today we're learning how to set up a PlayStation 3 controller on PC. Yes, that's right, an old PS3 controller working on PC. Now, here at Eddie 04 TV, we have learned how to set up a PlayStation 1, PlayStation 2, even a PlayStation 4 DualShock, and a PlayStation 5 DualSense controller on PC. Now, if you're interested in setting up your PS3 controller, let's cut to the chase. By the way, make sure to watch all the way through the end for a bonus tip on using the SCP driver. So for this method, you'll need a mini USB cable. You will also need the SCP driver and a PS3 controller. Now, if you're interested in connecting your controller on Bluetooth, you will need an additional Bluetooth dongle. A separate dongle is suggested since it requires the adapter to be solely dedicated for the SCP service. Unfortunately, you will not be able to use other Bluetooth devices, at least not with this solution. And specifically, if you're going to be using the in-house Bluetooth settings for your computer, I wouldn't recommend that. The SCP driver is an open source driver which allows the DualShock 2, DualShock 3, and even DualShock 4 to work on Microsoft Windows natively. This means these controls will be recognized as X inputs, which are also known as the Xbox 360 controller. So as you can see here, we got a PS3 controller and we just plugged into the computer using a mini USB cable. Now in Windows 10, it's gonna be detected as a PlayStation 3 controller. But since the drivers are not compatible, the gamepad won't really respond to our inputs. Now that the PlayStation 3 controller is plugged in, I would recommend going to the control panel and checking your controller to see if it has been detected correctly. In Windows 10, it's gonna be detected as a PlayStation 3 controller, but since the drivers are not compatible, the gamepad won't really respond to our inputs. So the first thing we're gonna do is extract the SCP drivers to any location. Now, the latest version is actually .175, so we'll need to also download that one. We're gonna install the 160 and then update to the latest version available for the SCP drivers. Now, these files are added in the description below to make your life easier. As you can see here, we have all the files already allocated, and now we're gonna go to our 175 update, and the only thing we need to do is replace the bin folder in here. That's about it. Okay, so the next step is to go to Program Files, and we're gonna go ahead and create a new folder. So you could either do this either by clicking New Folder or right-clicking, clicking on New, and then click on Folder. And we're gonna call this new folder scarlet.crush/productions. I also included a full compressed package with the Scarlet folder ready to use, so you don't have to either download the files or anything, just download it and put it in there. Okay, so now we'll dive into the Scarlet file folder and we're gonna drop in our SCP server files. And we're gonna look for bin. And we wanna specify the two files that we're gonna be using. In this case, we want the scp-driver.exe and the scp-monitor.exe. The first one is for driver installation, and the scp-monitor is just for tracking and checking the PS3 controllers connected and mapped into your PC. We're gonna run this as an administrator. Now here, the SCP driver installation, you have a couple of options where you can configure the service, and you can have also the Bluetooth driver. Now, for this tutorial, we will first uncheck the Bluetooth driver, and we're just gonna go ahead and click on install.
Now, as you can see, you can go ahead and check the latest installation summary. You can check out, and it says SCP DS3 service, bus device, bus driver, and DS3 USB driver. Now, if I go here, you'll notice that I now have a PS3 controller as well as an Xbox 360 controller for Windows. Now that we are here, we're going to run the scp-driver.exe file, and you want to make sure to run it as an administrator. Now, I open also the device and printers because I want to show you how it will look when it's installed. In this case, the SCP driver installer, it will show up just like this, and it will confirm that it's in version 175, and you'll see you have your configure service checked as well as the Bluetooth driver. For this tutorial, we'll first uncheck the Bluetooth driver and hit on install. Now, as you can see, there's a confirmation where it says SCP DS3 service has been installed, bus device, bus driver, and DS3 USB driver has been installed. This means that now your PlayStation 3 controller has been reconfigured as an Xbox 360 controller for an X input service. Okay, so once we are here, I can go ahead and test my PS3 controller, and you'll see that it is actually responding to my buttons press. Also, if I go to the Xbox 360 controller, with the same PS3 controller, I can test and it would also respond to my inputs. Now, I personally like, just to make your life easier, just right click on the SCP monitor and send it over into your start section. So that way you can easily access the monitor whenever you want to, just by pinning that into the start. So now, as you can see, I have it pinned. And if I open up the SCP monitor, pretty much it just shows me that I have a PlayStation 3 on the very first position. That's why it says pad 1 is a DS3 controller. This is the MAC address, this is a USB, and currently is getting data within my computer. And is obviously charging. Now, you do not need to run the SCP monitor, but it's a good way to verify or confirm that your PlayStation 3 controller is actually connected. And if you add more PlayStation 3 controllers, they're going to be positioning depending on which order you have them right there. As you know, we like testing games here, and we're going to be using Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 4 with a PS3 controller. And yes, that's right, we got PlayStation buttons in our Naruto game. As a matter of fact, we made a video tutorial on how to do this. Check it up here.
Thanks for getting this far into the video. Now for the bonus tip, make sure to smash that like button. Now that you have done that, let's go ahead and connect our PS3 controller through Bluetooth. Now remember to use a separate Bluetooth dongle with the SCP driver. Otherwise, you won't be able to connect mice or keyboards, speakers, or any other Bluetooth device through the same connection.
Okay, so for the bonus tip, we're gonna go ahead and connect the PS3 controller using the SCP driver through Bluetooth. Now, I'm going to be using this little USB Bluetooth dongle. If you want some suggestions, you can go ahead and check the links in the description below. Now, we're going to go ahead and plug this in. I personally like uninstalling the SCP driver first because I want to start with a clean slate. You don't have to do this, but that's just what I like doing. I want to make sure that there's nothing installed in my computer, at least for the SCP driver. So the next thing I want to do is plug in again my PS3 controller, right? And that is going to be detected. I'm going to go ahead and show you that right now we have the PS3 controller detected here. And we're going to run once again the SCP driver. Make sure to run it as an administrator. And this time you want to make sure that your Bluetooth driver checkbox is checked. Then go ahead and click on install. Now, because we have the PS3 controller connected through Bluetooth, and we also have the Bluetooth driver checkbox set, you're going to notice that the installation summary will show you the DS3 USB driver, which is obviously the wired connection, and then also the Bluetooth driver. After that, you can go ahead and exit. Now, the next step here is that you want to go to this folder here that is called Zadig. And go into Zadig, you want to run the Zadig.exe as an administrator. Now, you can go ahead and choose from the device list your USB Bluetooth dongle. I want to point out that it's very important to make sure which one is your USB Bluetooth dongle. Now, if you don't know how to check this out, you can do a little bit of trial and error and go to the device manager. Now, for me, I already know that my USB Bluetooth dongle is going to be the BCM2072A0. Now, if you're not able to list down your devices, it's okay. Just go ahead and click on options and click on list all devices. Now here, all your USB devices are going to be showing up. But what you want to do is click on the drop-down list and look for your USB Bluetooth dongle. In this case, I already know there's going to be the BCM2072A0. Now, after I do that, I'm going to go ahead and click on upgrade driver. Now, this is going to take a couple of minutes, the installation process. I know it might tell you to restart your computer. Don't do so until the driver has been successfully installed in your USB device. So the driver was installed successfully. Now we're going to go ahead and restart our computer. I personally test this out without restarting the computer, but if you need to or you want to, go ahead and restart it. Now we can go ahead and close Zadig, and we're going to go back into our SCP server bin folder. Now we already have the driver installed. We already have the Zadig functionality of transferring the Bluetooth driver into the USB Bluetooth dongle. The next thing you want to do is run the SCP monitor. Now in the SCP monitor, you'll notice that you already have a host address. That host address is your Bluetooth dongle. And we already have our PS3 controller connected. As you can see, it actually shows up here as DS3 with the MAC address, and it shows USB charging. Now the next step here is really straightforward. What you want to do is unplug the PS3 controller, and in just a couple of seconds, you'll notice that it changed from USB to BTH, which is Bluetooth, and it's showing you full because of a full charge. As you know, we like testing things out, so we're going to go to game controller settings, we're going to go to properties, and with our PS3 controller, without any cables, is responding. We're going to go ahead and load up Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 4 once again to verify that it's actually working on Bluetooth. Bruh. Hey, thanks for watching. For more videos like this, make sure to subscribe to the channel and click on the notification bell so you can be notified whenever I release a brand new video. For awesome videos like this, go ahead and watch here. And for another tutorial on game controllers, watch here. This is Eddie04. See you on the next one.